Hi there, my name is Hector Socas-Navarro, and I would like to show you my my latest DT project, which I call Motion Harp. As you have seen, the idea is that I wave my hands in the air here, and those hand gestures are translated into music that is being played by my keyboard here. So the way this works is I use the lip motion device, which reads the position of my fingers in three dimensions. And then that information is transferred to my laptop, where I'm running an algorithm that is actually pretty smart, and it knows a lot about music theory. And so what it does is it makes sure that whatever you do, it takes that pattern and it makes sure that the outcome is something that sounds pleasant to the ear. So the algorithm knows which notes go well with each other note, and it will only play notes that are harmonic, right? So the idea is that right from the beginning, even if you don't know anything about music, even if you don't know how to play an instrument, you can go to the motion harp and wave your hands, and it will sound nice. So that's the idea. This project is actually something I started quite a while ago, and what I'm going to show you is an improvement of a previous version. I actually made a video about that. You can watch it here if you want. But don't worry about it. This version is much improved. It is way better in every respect. And one of my favorite things that I've implemented here is a new mode that I call the play-along mode. Check it out. So, I can assure you that it's extremely fun to play this way. It's a lot of fun, and it's very, very nice. So the way this works is that you have to introduce some data about the song first in the algorithm. You basically have to provide the sequence of chords, and then it will go through the chords of the song. You'll play the song, and then the music or the patterns that you make with your hand will be converted by the algorithm into notes that will be consistent with those chords. So the key here, like I said, is that the algorithm knows about music theory, so you don't have to, right? It does all the hard part. It does the calculations of what notes you should be playing and what notes you should be avoiding, and it does that for you. Actually, it's a little more complicated than that, because it doesn't comply strictly with the rules of harmony. There is some room for imperfections, and in fact, this is a parameter that you can tweak. You can adjust the slider to specify that you want strict compliance with harmony rules. And that sounds very nice, it sounds very pleasant to the ear, but it can sound a little too perfect. So in music, sometimes you want to have also some dissonances that will add some color to the music. And so the algorithm allows for that, some departures from those rules. And in fact, you can fine-tune that, and you can do it even differently for the left and the right hand. Because typically for your left hand, you want to have much more strict compliance with harmony, and then the right hand, you might want to have some more freedom. So you can go all the way from strict compliance to completely free form. I wouldn't do that. I think the optimal setting is to have it somewhere between 70 and 80% compliance for the right hand and strict compliance for the left hand. And just let the algorithm do the job. Let me show you another example of how this works. So we're back in normal play mode, and what you do is the algorithm recognizes the position of your fingers, and it will find the closest note to the note that you're trying to play and correct it. So it will correct the note that you're trying to play and replace it with the closest note that is actually consistent with the chord that is being played. So it enforces compliance with the harmony rules. So that's the key. And there's actually different ways you can do that. Like I said, you have to program in advance what is the sequence of chords that you want to be playing around with. And there's different gestures that you can use to change chords and things like that. I'm not going into the details. But depending on the chords that you have instructed the algorithm to use, you can have different music styles. For instance, what I just played is a very canonical sequence of chords. This is probably what you would have in classical music. So if you have a Mozart composition, that will be the sequence of chords that you would have there. And this music resembles that a little bit. But you could also use different combinations. For example, with jazz, typically is a kind of music that has more complicated variations of chords. And it would probably sound more like this. So there's a lot of different things that you can do. You can play with the configuration to change the outcome. So I think the really nice thing about this is that you can enjoy playing music and making music even if you have no idea how to play an instrument, right? If you go to a conventional keyboard and you've never played, it's going to sound horrible, right? That's because you're pressing keys at random and those keys don't match with each other. In order to play something that is going to sound nice, you have to know these rules and you have to play notes that go well with each other. And that takes a lot of time. So I think technology, the future of technology in art and music is to sort of release us, to free us from the hard work that it implies to become a skilled player of any instrument. It takes many years of your life with very very high dedication, with a lot of dedication, to really learn how to play an instrument. And all of that work is basically is dull work, is repetitive, tedious work. And so I think what technology would allow us to do is to set us free from that tedious work and focus on the creative part. So somebody can be an artist even if they don't master the technique to play an instrument. And so this is a step in that direction. It follows that that philosophy of trying to free you from having to learn the technique to play well an instrument. The idea is that even if you've never played before, I mean, a four-year-old child could probably come here and make some music that sounds nice. So so the idea is that people can focus on the more creative part. I'm not really good at that, by the way. Hopefully some people out there with more creative minds can take something like this and produce some really nice compositions. And the idea, like I said, is that you basically you focus on the flow of the music, on the patterns that it has to follow, the sort of the more creative part, and you don't have to worry so much about the technique and about playing the right way and having to practice over and over again to really learn how to play well. So anyway, that's it in a nutshell. So I will be releasing the source code of this algorithm and writing some detailed instructions. I don't want to bore you with the details of how this works now, but I just hope I hope you like it. I think it sounds very nice. And yeah, I'm really happy with this play-along mode that I showed you, where I think it's extremely cool. You have no idea how much fun it is to play like this. In a way, it's kind of like a reverse karaoke, right? I could say actually that I've been playing the piano for Freddie Mercury, which is very, very cool. So anyway, okay, that's it. Thanks for watching. I hope you like it. Thanks, bye-bye.